Right. So here's the next one. It's basically called as a minor sixth chord. So let's first form the minor sixth chord. If you take A flat minor, which is A flat, B, D sharp or E flat, to get that minor sixth, it's essentially a minor chord with a major sixth on top. So it's a little tricky to remember. So how do you remember a minor sixth? It's a minor chord with a major sixth up top. It's not a minor sixth interval. It's a major sixth up top. So minor chord with a major sixth. So the way I use it very often is okay. The context of using this is a very plagal cadence-like context. So what we mean by a plagal cadence is a four chord going to the one chord. Okay, so generally what happens in a traditional plagal cadence, we go four, A flat in this case, going to E flat. So that's also called as an amen cadence or a church cadence. Amen, usually at the end of a hymn. A lot of people use it. Be speaking words of wisdom, let it be. Used a lot there. So a lot of composers use this at the end of a phrase, right? So you have tons of those songs, but what happens in some songs, like if you take Radiohead's Creep, right? Na 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 na. Okay, or Billie Eilish's My Future. Or even maybe the ending of Eric Clapton's Layla in the electric version. Okay, it's very common. A lot of rock bands, a lot of artists use it. Okay, so I use it also in a very traditional way. I don't think I have a very different way of using it, but it's just something to know. What I'd like to add is, first of all, it is the four of the one. So if you're in the key of E flat, the four is A flat. So traditionally in the E flat scale, we go na 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 na, B da 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 da. A flat major going to E flat, but the first thing you try and do is A flat minor, change that around, and then go to E flat major, right? That doesn't become the amen cadence anymore, it becomes something else unique. La, da, 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 de, da, de, da, da, da. You could even do major fourth going to the minor fourth chord, and then back to normal. So how we color the minor chord even more is we add that minor sixth element, making it again very James Bond like. Na, na, na. Okay. And this has actually motivated me as a composer to put these two chords together along with the tonic to build a scale out of those two chords, you know? So that's na, da, 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 de, 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 da, 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 da. So it's a very interesting scale. I love this scale. It's also known as a Mixolydian flat six scale. Instead of that, we do get progressions like la da da di da da da. So actually la da 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 di di da 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 do do. just something to note. So in a nutshell, minor chord with a major sixth, that's your minor major sixth. Very interesting, very mysterious, but could be used to resolve in a plagal context. That's a 4 going 2 1, right? 4 going 2 1. Or you could look at the bigger scale formed out of these two chords, which could be a Mixolydian scale with a flat 6. Mixolydian is essentially flat 7, and then you add the flat 6 as well. So Mixo flat 6 is the name of the scale. So these are various ways to use this chord into perspective. Let's move on.